you can never be right 100% of the time when it comes to trading. Try being wrong 100% of the time and you will still find it impossible as well. It's impossible to trade and not find yourself in a trade that loses money. That's just part and parcel of trading. Dealing with a large trading loss can be a devastating experience, and I don't just mean financially, but also emotionally. Many times, traders give up not because they have lost all of their money, but rather because they have lost all of their emotional capital. I want to share 7 tips to help you master trading psychology and discipline in today's video. As defeating as losses feel, how you react to a loss is more important than the loss itself. This video will help you to respond appropriately, so make sure to watch it till the end. Inexperienced traders who do not know how to respond appropriately end up self-sabotaging themselves when they get emotional. They might revenge trade, withdraw from the market to avoid thinking about the loss, or chase after subpar setups in an attempt to recover their losses. Regardless of which of the reactions they choose above, none of these are constructive in helping them become a successful trader. On the other hand, successful traders treat losses as an opportunity to learn and use it to sharpen their trading. Before I move on to tip number one, we are currently doing a giveaway for our premium Forex Signals, which we usually charge $99 a month. Now, if you want to participate in this giveaway, look for an emoji throughout this video. Once you find an emoji, like this video and comment what the emoji is plus Forex Signals in the comment section. We will announce lucky winner in the next video, so make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to know when the next video is released and whether you have won. Tip number one, never have bad days that cost you more than how much you typically make on a good day. Having a losing day is to be expected. It's just the way trading is. If you win an average of $1,000 a day, avoid losing more than $1,000 a day on your bad days. If you enforce this rule into your risk management, you are setting yourself up for success by winning more than you lose. Knowing how to minimize your losses is a very crucial aspect of trading. Maximizing gains is just half of the equation. Minimizing losses is the other half. You need both if you want to become a successful trader. When it comes to trading, there are only 4 possible outcomes. You can either have a big win, a small win, a small loss, or a big loss. The winners usually take care of themselves, but not the losses. As long as we can eliminate the big losses, then you have an excellent chance of becoming a profitable trader. I can't overemphasize that risk management is critical. It is better to have a mediocre strategy with sound risk management than a high probability strategy with poor risk management. It will make or break your account. Tip number two, avoid revenge trading. This rides on to tip number one. Just as it is vital to avoid the big losses, you also don't want to be revenge trading and chase after the market in an attempt to recover your losses. After a big loss or a series of losing trades, there's no way to trade with a clear state of mind. The market is always there for you, so there's no need to rush into trades when you're not taking straight. Well, if you jump back into trades without sticking to your trading strategy, then you are essentially revenge trading. This is very dangerous for 2 reasons, and I want to break it down for you. So make sure you listen closely and keep watching. Firstly, you are deviating from your trading strategy and throwing discipline out of the window. It shifts your focus from being process-orientated to being result-orientated. Remember that you have no control over each trade's results, and you only have control over the process. Secondly, nothing positive can come out of revenge trading. If you lose, you dig yourself further into the hole that you are in with trades that you don't even know work or not. And if your trades do turn out to make money, it is still a bad thing because you will now believe that trading based on your emotions and abandoning your trading strategy is totally fine. This conditions you to do it repeatedly and wonder why you have issues staying disciplined and sticking to your trading strategy. Later on in this video, I will show you what to do instead of revenge trading. So make sure you watch this video till the end. Tip number 3. Always insert a stop loss and know when you're getting out. Inputting a stop loss for every single trade is a must. You should always know when you're getting out before you enter a trade. The right way to view stop loss is like an insurance policy. You hope you never use it, but you still have it in case anything goes wrong. A common mistake made by beginners is that they have a stop loss, but they keep widening their stop loss as the market trades against them. Rather than taking the loss and cutting it short, they do the opposite and hold on to losing trades, hoping that it will turn around. Remember that a singular winning or losing trade should never make or break your trading account. If it does, then you are gambling, not trading. Tip number 4. Always assume responsibility. Here's the thing. If you blame others, you don't learn. Because when something isn't your fault, then there is nothing you can do about it. Blaming others is admitting you are not in charge of your trading account. If you suffered a large loss, the next best thing apart from avoiding it is to learn from it. Think of it this way. If you spend $10,000 on a trading course, would you not do your best to learn whatever you can from it? Similarly, you want to learn as much as you can from experience. Don't brush the loss aside or start pointing fingers. There's always an excuse if you want to find one. Accept the responsibility and figure out what should have been done instead. Tip number 5. When you are tired, learn to take a break, not quit. After incurring a big loss, it is wise to take a break and slowly reflect on what went wrong so that you can make tweaks. Taking a break does not equate to quitting, and often it will save you from losing more money. Ask yourself where you fell short. Did the strategy stop working? Did you follow your trading plan? Did you overtrade? Taking some time off the market and reflecting on these questions is one of the hardest things to do, especially when your instinct is to recover back all the money you lost. But it is perhaps one of the wisest things you can do. As I mentioned, the market will always be there for you and won't run away. You don't have to worry about missing opportunities because there will always be plenty. If you really can't discipline yourself to stay away from the market, then the next tip will help you tremendously. Tip number 6. Adopt smaller position size or demo trade to build confidence. After a big loss, your trading psychology is weak, and there's no reason to be trading big positions. When your trading psychology is weak, it will likely cause you to skip profitable trades, exit out of good trades, or be overly aggressive in chasing after the market. None of these are good, and it's better to adopt a smaller position size. Your goal is not so much to make money, but rather to build back your confidence. You can also return to a demo account to do this. There is less pressure on a demo account, and thus it is much easier to focus on your execution instead of worrying about the outcome of the trade. A couple of well-executed winning trades will do wonders for your confidence and put you in the right state of mind to trade the markets. So remember that your goal is not to revenge trade and make back the money. Your goal is to start small and build your confidence before resuming your original position size. Bouncing back from a big loss is about going back to your trading strategy and executing it well, not so much about making money. When you execute your trading strategy well, money flows into your account naturally. Tip number 7. Realize that the outcome is outside your control. Here's the cold hard truth of trading. You can do everything right and still lose money. When you truly understand and accept this, it is so liberating. The outcome of each trade is outside your control, but the execution process is within your control. Some of your biggest lessons will come from your mistakes, so embrace them, but more importantly, learn from them. It does you no good to suffer the losses, embrace them, and not learn from them. Losing money should motivate you to re-examine your approach to trading and tweak certain things. I hope you learned something useful from this video. Like this video, subscribe to the channel, and comment with the emoji plus forex signals to enter yourself into our giveaway. If you have not found the emoji, that's a sign that you haven't been paying attention. So pay closer attention and rewatch this video. The winner will be announced in the next video, so turn on the notification bell and check to see if you have won. I've also prepared a 3-day trading guide which you can download via the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next video.